Nights are hard and the falls are real. For the women of the New Hampshire Roller Derby League, there is nothing more exciting than this.
It's basically an extreme contact sport on four wheels. And the object of the game is for the jammer to skate around the rink and get through the pack. And the object of the blockers in the pack are to block that jammer from scoring any points. And there's two jammers, and they both are kind of in a race, whoever gets through first.
On a hot Saturday night at the JFK Coliseum in Manchester, members of the Skate Free or Die Roller Girls took part in their first ever hometown scrimmage.
We want to welcome you to the New Hampshire Roller Derby's first ever event. Thank you for coming out.
This event is our first ever public scrimmage bout that we've had in New Hampshire. We've been practicing for a year now. We formed our league a year ago in July, and this is the first time that we're actually holding a public event. We've had one prior scrimmage. We scrimmaged against Providence, Rhode Island. That was our first official public outing, but this is our first home match, so it's pretty exciting.
We got involved in it basically. About five girls started, wanted to skate a little bit, see where it came from, and it evolved into this sort of something bigger than we thought it was going to be.
The team has steadily grown over the past year from the original five members to now close to 45, made up of all sorts of women from all sorts of backgrounds.
There's all different kinds of people, there really are. We have from the mid-20s up until 40-somethings, all different walks of life. We have school teachers, we have stay-at-home moms, we've got business professionals, we've got nurses. I mean, we've got, you know, it just runs the gamut of types of people.
I think it's a sport that anybody can do. There's no specific type of person. There's no body type, or, you know, if you haven't skated since you were 15 or 16, you can still get on skates and do it.
These girls were starting the first league ever, so everybody was at the same level, so it was like, oh, I totally can do this now. Because it's like, they're beginning just as much as I am, and it'd be fun to do it, to be able to start something, you know, be part of, like, something way bigger than yourself.
Whatever your job is, you know, in your day job, at night you can become the persona that, you know, you want to, and you can play that way, and it's so much fun. I think it appeals to all different types of people.
Becoming a totally different person is obvious for some of these girls. You can see it the minute they walk into the room with wild outfits and outrageous hair.
There is a persona that over the years that has kind of, you know, the fishnets and, you know, the short shorts and the tattoos and everything, but it's not all about that. Obviously, I don't have any tattoos. It's a lot of fun. It's a way to get out there and be girly and dress up, and you know, I mean, if you like to do that type of thing, it's just like a showboating kind of fun way to express yourself.
People find this as, like, a few times a week I get to dress like whatever I want. I can be like whomever I want to be, four nights a week, and it's just like, nobody cares what you wear. They love seeing something different every time. So it's actually a really fun other aspect of it.
And you can't help but notice that every girl has a skater name.
Yep, it's kind of a rite of passage. You get a choice to pick your own name, and each skater all across the country has a unique skater name. There's a registry list. So if your name is similar to someone else's, you may have to either get permission from that skater or not take that name at all.
But let's not forget, this is a contact sport, and the chances that you could get hurt is real.
It happens. You can get hurt, but we do practice safety, and safety is really important, and you learn how to fall, and you learn how to hit properly, and you have to go through skating drills and assessment levels to even get to this point. So, you know, you already have a good foundation when you're out there. so it's pretty safe. I mean, there is the chance to get hurt is there. It's an extreme sport, no matter what, you know, it's there.
I enjoy the sport so much. And it's just the same as hockey or football, you know, it's the same kind of contact level. And it's so much fun, and it's become so dear to my heart that I wouldn't give it up for, you know, anything.
And from the looks of things, she won't have to worry. This sport isn't going anywhere anytime soon. So be on the lookout for the New Hampshire Roller Derby League. They could be rolling into your town soon.